What's up, you guys? You're watching Sergio's Secrets. Before I get started with today's video, if you can please give this video a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button. I post every single day until further notice, so it would really mean a lot to me if you guys can subscribe, and all the links for everything that I'm going to be talking about will be linked down below, because sometimes I do find stuff on sale to do the work for you, so if it is on sale on some website, I always link it down so it makes it more easier for you to find it. And today's requested video, I've been doing requested content, so if you guys have any video requests, I'm more than happy to hacer esos videos para ti. I have a lot of your requests, but do not get me wrong, I can take a lot more. Today's requested was, what are my favorite tote bags of all time that are perfect for work specifically, or they're going to be heavy duty? So I'm going to be mentioning designer and contemporary, so there's going to be bags ranging from $145 all the way to $1,500. I think all of these bags are wearable, usable, kind of like the other videos that I do, like my favorite crossbodies under $300, my favorite bags under $200, my favorite beginner handbags, which will all be linked down below. This could be one of those type of lists where anybody can wear it, that you can get a lot of wear out of them. And I'm including very, very popular handbags and handbags that people don't really talk about, that I've only seen a few times out and about, but are definitely underrated. So there's definitely gonna be something that you like. There's nylon, there is leather material. So I feel like in this video, you'll get a nice well-rounded, my favorite work totes. I would not be including like backpacks or, you know, messenger bags that are made for your laptop or made to put like folders and stuff. It's specifically gonna be a tote video. Now, if you do wanna see any other, some sort of videos, definitely leave them down below. And other than that, let's get started with today's video. The first bag that we're gonna talk about, which is the most kind of controversial bag that people always like to debate, and it is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. So the Louis Vuitton Neverfull, for me, I do think it's a great bag. Now, I will say, it is a basic bag. A lot of people do have this bag, but at the end of the day, it is popular for a reason and people really like it. Now, will this be a bag that I would get for myself eventually? Yes, I will eventually get myself a Neverfull to archive in my collection just so I can like have them behind me and I can reference them in videos, but I probably wouldn't wear it every single day or get a lot of wear out of it. It would just be an item that I would archive because I love YouTube. YouTube is my hobby, so I do want to have certain bags that I have in my collection to kind of show you versus me kind of showing you pictures. So I do see myself getting one. Maybe the next time I go to Europe, I will probably purchase one just so I can archive it in my collection. At the end of the day, the Neverfull is an iconic bag. It has been made since 2005 or 2006. I remember when this bag, when I was a kid, it was literally like $600 or $700, $800, and now it's a bag that's $1,410, $1,450, somewhere around that. The one that I would definitely choose is going to be the Bean one, which is the brown checkerboard. I would not suggest the Azure, just because I know it's canvas, but it gets a lot of wear and tear, and the monogram as well. I just don't like things that age very quickly, and for like that vachetta leather, I just don't like how it patinas over time. If you're caught in the rain, you know, it makes it more less user friendly to be using, so I wouldn't recommend that. The only one that I would recommend is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull and the Damier Abin and the GM size, which is the larger size, or the MM, which is the medium size. I think those two would be really, really great bags. I think you can wear them to work. You can fit your laptop up. You can fit a 13 inch, a 15 inch. You can fit all your folders. You can get like a handbag divider and just put all your stuff in there. I get emails about the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. What are my thoughts? Like I said, it's not my to-go bag. It's not a bag that I would go out and use every single day. Is a bag that collection to have, and yeah, I mean, it is an iconic bag. I know some people talk negatively of like the Neverfull, the Speedy, Alma. Those bags are Louis Vuitton's bread and butters. Those bags, it's what gives Louis Vuitton what it is. So for me, the Louis Vuitton Neverfull, first choice. I know this is probably the most thought about, my thoughts and my opinions on the Neverfull. I do like it, it's not for me, but I can definitely see how it's a very functional bag. And this bag has been out for 10 years, it will be out in the next 10 years, and the price will just keep going up, and I don't think it's ever gonna go out of style. And that pouch is also very user friendly as well. The second bag that I'm gonna be talking about today is from Tory Burch, and it is the iconic Perry Toe, which I own right here. I talk about this bag quite a lot on my channel. This one will fit a 13 inch laptop, and you'll actually have more space to put in more stuff. You can put your folders back for quite a bit of months. It is this kind of nice leather. What I like that it has this embossed Tory Burch. So, you know what I mean? If you don't want it, maybe if you take public transportation, or maybe if you don't, we want to be more discreet, you can literally go like boop, and it's like a classic tote. But, you know, these silhouettes, you can kind of tell that it is a Perry Toe. It is lined with Saffiano leather, so if anything happens, you can literally wipe it off. You can keep, you know, your laptop, well protected in here because it has a zip, so if you're caught in the rain or anything, side here. So I think this is a really great tote. It's nice, wipeable, user friendly. You can get a lot of wear out of it. And a lot of these bags that are work totes, for the most part, you can also transition into a weekend bag or a travel bag as, but not all of them. But I will have to say that the Perry tote is a really good work tote. It holds up. Like I said, it's not lined with fabric or anything, so if anything pasa, you can literally just get a little wipey, a disinfectant wipe, a little towel, and you can clean it up. And I feel like this is something you will get a lot of wear out of. This is one of Troy Burch's bread and butter handbags, so I decided to mention it. And a lot of people do really work as a work bag, and when I see people out and about, you know, doing their own things, maybe being on phone calls, if I'm having lunch and, you know, people are wearing their beautiful blazers, their beautiful outfits, and being phone calls, they look very perfect, they look very polished. So this one's $348. I think there are some versions of this one on sale. Like I said, I'll leave all the links down below, so you don't have to do any of the work. And but yeah, the Perry tote, I definitely do recommend, and I do think that it's a great bag, especially because it is $348. You can sometimes get them for $250 if they're on sale. So my second choice is going to be the Troy Burch. Well, I'm just gonna go ahead and just do by brand. So I did my Louis Vuitton bag, and then I have two other Troy Burch bags that I'm gonna be showing you. Tote that I think it's a really great one is from Troy Burch, and it's the Ella tote. As you can see, guys, I still have my coffee stains in it. I literally have coffee stains in this bag for like a month and a half, and I haven't had the chance to clean it off. But this one is in the size larger. There's like a smaller size, and then there's a mini size. I'm recommending this size because this size, it has a magnetic closure. It has these little snap closures, so you can snap it. And so it's pretty secure. No one can go inside, especially if you kind of tuck it right here. This magnet's pretty strong, so I don't see if anybody can go inside of it. It has the Troy Burch emblem, but like I said, you can just turn it around. This is a vegan bag from what I can tell, because this is faux leather, which I did not know that. I did some more research on this bag. So this is a vegan friendly bag if you're into not having bags that are made out of leather. This is faux leather, which is really great. So I mean, now I can say that this is a faux leather for my people that don't want to use any animal products. It has the iconic T on these two sides, and then in the back as well. And then on the inside, it has a pocket right here that's a pretty generous pocket as well. And it is lined with the Troy Burch kind of emblem throughout the bag. And when you see how bags are made, we work in the industry, you see the quality and the craftsmanship. Like for me, like this costs more money for them to embroider it throughout the bag than for them not to. So when you see the details, like the little T stitching right here, and when you see the little buttons, like all these are little added costs. This is a little Harris Bear when I went to London. So these are little added costs. The nylon is pretty durable. It's nice and thick, it's substantial. If you do put a lot, it will sag just a little bit, but honestly, it doesn't really bother me because I just carry my laptop and a few folders, so it should be fine. I don't really have a lot of issues, but if you do carry a little bit more, you can definitely you buy a little base shaper for it, but I like this. This comes in at $198. It's an iconic bag. It's been in her collection for, I want to say 6 or 7 years. So I'm going anywhere in her collection, and I don't see this bag going anywhere in my collection. So if you do want a bag that's under $200, that's vegan friendly, nylon, lightweight, transitional, this one's a really great work bag, and I really like this one. And yeah, so choice for totes is going to be the Troy Burch Ella tote. Now, the fourth one, which is going to be my last Troy Burch on this list, I just think Troy Burch has definitely knocked down how to make really great totes. And when you think about work bags, you really think about Troy Burch. So the next one I'm going to talk about is going to be the Robinson. So the Robinson comes in, it's a Saffiano bag. They have done many variations of this. They've had like the Parker, the York version. They've had like an older Robinson and newer Robinson. So this one has been really perfected for it to be the best work tote. So on the inside, there is a zipper. Fit your laptop in it, and then there's just so much compartments, like in the front where the T emblem is at, there's a little pocket right there that you can't really even tell there's a pocket in there, but you can put your cell phone in there. It's nice and deep. There's just a lot of compartments with like little pockets. You can put like your little charger, your SIM card, maybe like a pin. You can definitely divide everything and know where everything's at. So maybe if like the Louis Vuitton Neverfull or these other two Troy Burch totes where they may not have as much compartments, this one can't. It's Saffiano leather. You can wear it in the rain. You can wear it out and about. It's a great travel bag because anything happens with the Saffiano leather, like I said, no matter what, wipe it, clean it off, and you are good to go. And even if you do want to try a colored bag, let's say in a fun yellow color, blue or green, this type of leather. The Saffiano is a really great one to experiment with or just to have in your collection, just because it is Saffiano and it is hard wearing. So I do think it's a really great choice, and this is probably the number one tote bag by Troy Burch. When you think about a work tote for Troy Burch, it's definitely going to be the Robinson bag over the Perry, but I think all these ones are really great. It's all their bread and butters throughout the Troy Burch collection. Three bags have definitely been mentioned on my channel. So that is my fourth option. Now the fifth option that I have for you is going to be in another designer version. Now this is my mom's handbag. I bought this for her during Christmas and she loves it. She uses it every day as a work bag. And this one is going to be another designer bag that I'm going to be showing you. And let me go ahead and show it to you right now. Thank you so much for her for letting me borrow this bag to show on my channel. And it is from Christian Louboutin, and it is the iconic Kubota tote. Now, I will say I'm personally not the biggest Christian Louboutin fan. My mom does like Christian Louboutin, and I know a lot of people are Christian Louboutin lovers. So this one is the Kubota tote. I got her the leopard print, but there is an iconic black color, gray color, white color. They come in a lot of nice colors. Now, I know this one may not be for everybody, but I know that this is a very popular bag, and she is obsessed with this bag. So as you can see, it is a tote, and what I like about it is it has a Christian Louboutin like sneaker, but what you can put is a laptop folder. You can put so much, but since this has a strong base, nothing sags like the Louis Vuitton Neverfull. It just holds its structure, it holds its wear pretty well. And with the iconic red, so if you're looking for something very quickly, since it's red, you can kind of see everything that is black. It also comes with a pouch just like the Neverfull, and it is also detachable as well. It has a little zipper right here, and it is just a nice little on the inside. But on this tote right here, it has it's lined with this red iconic leather. And now I do think that the Christian Louboutin totes, or a lot of their bags, are very kind of hot. They're very out there. But if you do want to get more of the tapered one, definitely like the black one. But she loves this bag. During Christmas, I knew that she would love it, and when she opened it Christmas Day, she really liked it. So, her a lot for her giving me this bag to show in this video. But yes, I do think that the Christian Louboutin is a work bag she financed, so it's a grip bag and it's very appropriate. So, I thought I would mention another designer option, and this one is going to be the Christian Louboutin Kubota tote. About the next two bags are from an awesome brand called Dagny Dover. Now, I have a lot of Dagny Dover items. I have a duffel, backpack, fanny pack, makeup bag. I love their brand so much. I've been wearing a lot of the items for a while. So I have their backpack. I've had like a year and a half. I show it on my channel quite consistently. If you do want to see it on a full review on my Dagny Dover items, I have a video on my channel. I'll leave it linked down below. But those, I'm not necessarily talking about the items that I have in my collection. I'm talking about two bags particularly that I don't own. And this one that I'm showing you is the Signature Dagny Dover Tote. Now this tote right here is made out of 100% canvas. On the handles, they're nice and they're movable. They sit up straight, but you can definitely bend them inward or outward or whatever you need to do, and it doesn't lose its structure and it doesn't look funny. In a bunch of colors, like I said, kind of like a Robinson tote by Troy Burch. Now this is made out of canvas, coated canvas in particular. You can make it what you want it to be, and since it's canvas, it's going to be nice and hard wearing. Now it has a zipper, so it's nice and secure, so no one can go out. It has a little D-ring outside the back, so if you want to put a back charm, maybe hand sanitizer, because that's not what people are going to start carrying now, maybe a little back charm, your keys, you can put that in there, maybe mace. On the inside, it has a pocket that's padded for your laptop, so you can put a laptop case and then put it in there, and it's nice and padded. There's a little sleeve so you can put more folders. It has a little thing where you can put your water bottle so it doesn't move around. It has like a little hook where you can hook your keys so you know where it's at all times. Like, this bag is definitely has been perfected to the T. Dagny Dover is a brand where they think about the consumer. They think about his and hers lifestyle, things that will work, things that won't work. They're made for people that take public transportation, made for people that work 9 to 5, made people that are always on the go, always on the run, carefree, want something that will hold up really well. And the Dagny Dover Signature Canvas Tote, I believe, goes for $245 for the smaller version, and there's $265 for a larger version. And I believe right now they're 10% off. I'm not too sure, but like I said, I'll link it down below. But there are really great totes. I see a lot of people, I don't see a lot of people wear them as much as like the Troy Burch, some of the other totes. This one's a more understated, and it just will hold up a lot, and you can get a lot of wear out of it. So I thought I would mention the Dagny Dover tote, the signature canvas one. Dagny Dover is such an underrated brand. I don't really see a lot of people talk about it on YouTube, but it is a brand that I love to talk about because they make great quality products and they hold up pretty well in the price point. It is more of that contemporary price point, but they're very, very reasonable for what it is. And I just cannot say nothing negative about Dagny Dover, one of my absolute favorite work handbag brands, or one of my favorite handbag brands in general. Now the next one, maybe if you don't want canvas, you want something leather, I have this Stagging Dover option for you. It's kind of the same thing. It is a little bit more on your laptop. You can fit a lot more stuff in it. It's a really great tool. I believe this one comes in 345 and it comes in a bunch of leather. Stagging Dover also does really good leather. Like they do good neoprene, they good do canvas, and they do good leather. I wish it was a Stagging Dover store here in Dallas. The only place here in Dallas where you can buy Stagging Dover, I believe, is Bandeer in Highland Park and Nordstrom. I think those are the only two places, but they have a huge collection. You can see everything that they have, and they have basically everything, but I did want to mention this tote. It is a really great one. If you look at the reviews for all Stagging Dover items, literally 99.9 of them are always going to be very, very positive reviews. So I thought I would mention this tote right here. It's a really great one if you do want maybe more leather, or you like the look of this one a lot more. This one right here, it's a really great one as well. The bag that we're going to be talking about today is going to be the Longchamp Le Pliage tote. Guys, I actually own a Le Pliage in my collection. I've had this one for a year and a half. It is my bread and butter. I actually have the older version. There is a newer version of this bag that you can actually adjust the strap on it, so you can make it a little bit more shorter, a little bit longer, and it's still the same price as the older version. So the one that I have is the black on black. I'm picking old Longchamp bags that are nylon that can fit a laptop. Longchamp is known for being a work bag. When you see people in Manhattan, you know, you see people carrying their Chanel bags, or maybe their leather bags, or maybe a smaller bag, and you see people carrying their work bag as a Longchamp bag, or you just see people just carrying this Longchamp as regular. When I went to London, I was so shocked. I know people say like people in Europe carry a lot of Longchamp bags, but I was so shocked in the amount when I was at the Tube, when I was out and about. Everybody literally had a Longchamp bag. I know Monterrey, like in Mexico, everyone has a little Longchamp bag. They're just made really well. The price point's really good. They're made to last. I know I've seen some people say about the wear on the corners. For me, I've used this bag quite a lot and I've experienced nothing on the corner. Obviously, if you use the bag for like 4 or 5 years and you beat it up, obviously it is gonna have wear. You know what I mean? These bags are also, they're made nice, they're made really well, but they're, you know, an item that you're supposed to take care of. You know, if you throw it around, you will maybe pay the consequences to have a little bit of things, but if you used it a lot, then I think you got your money's worth. But I think this, I've got my money's worth out of this. This is a bag that I will never sell. I will always have this bag in my collection. This fits a laptop, it fits everything. Now it may lack a little bit of structure. You can always buy a little base shaper, or just carry it like that. I've carried my laptop. I carried all my folders, everything in here. It's a good mommy bag. It's just such an all-around good bag. I prefer the one with the strap just because it makes it more easier. You're not limited to these short handles. But just in general, the Longchamp tote, they're known for a lot. And this is going to be the lowest price point in this video, the 145 version. But you can definitely go more for the premium ones with the straps on them. But I will say that the Longchamp totes are worth the money. And if you do want a classic nylon bag that will hold up pretty well, just like the Troy Burch Ella tote, this is another alternative, just because this one has a full zipper and a strap, versus the Ella tote may not have that. So if you're looking for a strap or maybe a zipper, maybe this one will be a little bit more of a better choice than the Ella. But then the Ella one's also a little bit more bigger. It has a pocket, has a zipper and a pocket, but this one just has a very, very small pocket. So it has its pros and cons, but I do really like both of these nylon bags, and both of them will never be leaving my collection. I'm always going to be having them. Next bag that we need to talk about is going to be the MZ Wallace Metro Tote. Another nylon bag. I promise to be my last nylon bag in this video. But this bag is iconic. Also, in London, I didn't know, like, MZ, I thought MZ Wallace was more of an American brand. But I saw a lot of people, I even saw guys carrying, like, the MZ Wallace backpack, which I thought were pretty cute. So I may buy a black-on-black MZ Wallace backpack. But the actual tote, like, it's such a great tote. Like, I was just shocked by the amount of MZ Wallace that I also saw. And it has a zipper. This nylon is a little bit more lightweight. It is not as thick as the Longchamp and as the Ella. So if you want something that's even lighter, this one's a really great one. It is quilted all around. It has feet at the bottom. It has little vachetta leather on it. It has a zipper. It comes with a pouch on the inside. This one's also a really great bag as well. Maybe they're not as popular as like the Ella tote or the Longchamp tote is what I see here in Dallas. You want something that's a little bit more different than your Ella tote or your Longchamp tote, but that's still great that you'll still get a lot of wear out of. It's going to be the MZ Wallace. So I'm excited that I introduced MZ Wallace on my channel. I know I have not talked about it yet, but you will be seeing me talking about MZ Wallace more. And I can see an MZ Wallace in my collection pretty soon on this channel, an unboxing. So who knows, we'll see. But MZ Wallace Metro Tote, I definitely have to recommend, and they hold up pretty well. I've seen some that are a little bit more older that still look pretty good, and I see some that are newer that are obviously brand new looking good. So I just think that nylon bag is very nice. It's lightweight, it's weatherproof, so I thought I would mention the MZ Wallace Metro Tote. For the last bag that I've been mentioning on my channel, it's going to be, okay, you ready guys? And it's going to be the Kate Spade Margot Tote. Now you may say, Sergio, oh my god, the Margot Tote does not fit a laptop. I know, guys, I know it doesn't fit a laptop. I wish it did. Actually, four sizes in this bag. So there is a mini size, a small size, a medium size, and the laptop size. Now, a lot of the Margot bags are on sale because I believe Kate Spade is having like a 50% off sale. So I'll link them down below if I can find them. But the Margot Tote is their bread and butter. When you think about Kate Spade, you know, you think about the Margot. It's the leather's nice and wearable. You can, it's kind of like the Perry Tote by Troy Burch. You can wipe it off. It's very good. On the inside, it has a zipper. You can put your laptop in there for the larger version. And I just think it's a really, really great bag by Kate Spade. I know Kate Spade hasn't been getting a lot of attention recently on YouTube. I feel like people have been moving on to other brands or talking about more brands. But I definitely do want to talk about Kate Spade. Kate Spade is an OG in the handbag game. And I definitely do want to go to the Kate Spade store once it opens and play around and kind of show you all the type of models and all the type of bags that they have. Just because I think Kate Spade's an excellent handbag brand. They're actually the same brand as Stuart Weitzman and Coach, if you don't. So I just think that, you know, ever since they've been owned by Coach and Stuart Weitzman, they have done a lot of changes, but I think a lot of changes that benefits us as a consumer by making maybe products a little bit more durable, more wearable, and the price points are a little bit more better. So I just think that the Margot Tote is a really great bag. I like it. Like I said, it's a bread and butter for Kate Spade. I would recommend as a laptop. I just think it looks very sleek. Also doesn't really have a lot of hardware in it. It does have feet at the bottom. I will say that I appreciate that. But the only really hardware you see is on the zipper, which is a light pale. So you can definitely put your gold or your silver jewelry or rose gold away. So you can dress this up, you can dress this down, and the Margot Tote is a really great bag, and these are going to be my top 10 favorite totes, including contemporary and designer. Hope you guys like this list. If there's any totes that I'm missing, definitely leave them down below. I would love to hear the conversations. I try to include stuff from, like I said, $145 to $1,500. This is a nice mix of totes. There's other totes that I like as well, like totes like, there is like more Longchamp totes that are really great, and more, and there's an MCM Classic Liz tote that's really great as well. So there are a few that I missed, but I definitely wanted this to be a little bit more edited by just choosing 10 handbags. But yeah, these are going to be all really great work bags for, you know, to travel, to mommy bag, to work bag, but particularly this video is more for work. So if you're looking for any of these bags, I highly recommend them. I would look at other YouTube videos reviews. Like I said, I have some reviews on some of these items, which I'll leave linked down below. And do your research, guys, and a lot of stuff is on sale. So if you want to purchase any of these bags, right now is a really great incentive because like Dagny Dover and Kate Spade, they're all having sales. But like I said, I'll find all the links for you guys down below, so you have to, guys have to look for them. I'll do the job for you. And yeah, this is Sergio's Secrets. I really appreciate you guys mirando estos videos. I'm posting a video every single day. So if you guys have any video requests, definitely leave them down below. And thank you so much for mirando mi video. And I'll see you guys on the next one. And yeah, bye guys. I can't thank you much enough for watching my content. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.